prepare to ball. And so tonight we're northward bound. Our tale is from a Yorkshire town. Near to this town they have a mine where good and evil intertwine. Our heroes in this mine spelunk, but will they evil myths debunk? Let's hope at least they have some fun. Do wish them luck, for here they come. Woo!
Today is the day that we finally sell my family mine. The potential buyer is Dame Ivanna Sukyoff, eccentric entrepreneur with an unfortunately named Russian billionaire parent. I am certain she won't be able to refuse our offer. Now, recite the plan for me, George.
Well, as the humble yet very skilled farmer this here mine, I shall attempt to woo the beautiful Dame Ivanna with my many talents. She will first be sucked in by my wit and charm, and then she'll be blown away by several tons of industrial explosives. By which I mean I'll blow a bloody great hole in one, she'll be well impressed. She will naturally buy the mine, netting you a tidy profit. You'll be able to buy that house in Cornwall you've always wanted to save your crumbling marriage.
No! That's quite enough, thanks.
Hey, darling.
Hello.
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 Hello. Hello. Buttock family mine. Naturally, I am Rupert Buttock, and it is simply wonderful to have you here. First, I'd like to introduce you to George, our foreman.
Pleasure's all mine, love.
Copyright.
And that I say, what a looker you are.
Ooh, what a charmer.
Yes, isn't she? Do you tell me, Dame Ivanna, whilst we're getting acquainted, do you have much experience with mining?
Oh, I certainly know my way around the shaft.
Fantastic. Whilst we're on topic, George, would you like to show something to Dame Ivanna?
Just one or two things, eh, boss? Do you have any idea what this might be?
Well, it looks like a pump to me. To inflate a girlfriend, perhaps.
No, you joker. No. This here is a detonation device which I shall skillfully use to blow a bloody great hole in the wall and make you a special new wing on this mine just for you.
Bear in mind, if you purchase the mine, this new wing may bring you many millions of pounds in untouched resources.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. Do you reckon I could do this?
No, no, no. This is a very delicate piece of kit. You have to go on a course to use this. No, best leave a professional to do her work. Stand back and cover your ears. All right, on five. Five.
Did it exist there in the earth? They've made mistakes before they learn, before their journey takes a turn.
Do you still hear that?
What could be all the way down here? It's a kind of monster!
No, don't be silly. It's probably just a rat.
Well, whichever it is, it's getting closer!
You guys there, show yourself at once.
Goblin and the daddy. Each other very
much. Oh, Derek, that's not what they were getting at all. The great creator made the goblin race around 400 years ago. He made the first two goblins, Robin and Steve, out of limestone in his mother-in-law's image.
That's ridiculous. God only works with clay.
Then they must have been put in here by Satan!
Please, I fear we may have gotten off on the wrong foot. I am Kevin, and that's Derek. We are agents of her most dear, benevolent, kind, just, loving, generous, beautiful, honest, magnanimous, and gentle majesty, the Goblin Queen.
Good to meet you.
The pleasure is all mine. Now, I have a fair few questions I'd like to ask, as I'm sure you do as well. But first, protocol instructs me to take you straight to the Goblin Queen herself.
Oh, Kevin, you and your bloody protocol.
That sounds pretty good to me. I've never met royalty.
There is one slight hiccup. I will have to take you to her blindfolded.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Kevin!
It is protocol, Derek! Ignorant blink! Now, you have my word. Nothing bad will happen to you in the slightest.
Oh, I don't know. Last time I was blindfolded, some bad things certainly did happen.
What should we do? Should we be blindfolded? Does it sound like a good idea?
Yeah!
I don't think so.
Done a bit of thinking, and I think we're ready to meet this Goblin Queen of yours. Oh, fantastic! Her Majesty will be delighted to receive three people at once. Now.
So the humans did give in to Kevin's quite untempting whim. In darkness deep they on were led, in goblins' past they gently tread. But what awaited in the mind? The Goblin Queen would hit them blind. Was this so that they could not fight, or just to ease them of the sight of goblins, odd and small and pale, in whose dark lair the humans wail?
Oh, my dear most benevolent, kind, loving, generous, just, beautiful, merciful, honest, my manners, and gentle majesty. I have brought three human interlopers down wandering in the mines. Derek!
My love is pure.
lady, I were too distracted by your beauty. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. It's true.
George, for the love of God, stop being such a James Blunt.
Please, the monocled gentleman, don't scold the grubby creature. She is the voice of an angel. It's been a long time since I was last serenaded so sweetly. Kevin here has told me everything I need to know.
I'm sorry, Your Majesty. I should not have been so rude.
Stand up.
What is wrong with you?
It is an interesting predicament you found yourselves in. But I believe we can help you to escape our humble abode. If you help us with a problem of our own.
Your Majesty, Chapter 240, Section 23 of the Goblins Interaction Act.
Oh, shut the fuck up, Kevin, you boring bastard!
There are rules for a reason.
Silence! The circumstances we're in merit an exception to normal procedure, Kevin. Now, for some time, our peaceful goblin commune, to which you are all welcome as guests, has been pestered by a nefarious evil. Some say it was born of the hatred and rage of the Republic Goblins. Others blame the Corby Goblins and the British for anarchy. All we know is that from some dark force arose the very incarnation of evil itself. Oh,
please, Your Majesty, don't say his name.
The Evil Goblin Overlord!
Ha ha ha! And a special welcome to our special guest, President Trump. Big off! Congratulations, I'm sure, from all of us on your election result. You really smashed it.
Well, I mean, we all knew that I was going to do well. I played the game. I am the best at playing the game. And we all knew not that many people would vote for a woman.
Well, we all certainly knew there were enough morons to vote for you over the pond. Our interest, how is Plan B coming along?
Plan B? Oh, Plan B, it's huge, it's fantastic. Oh, threw them all off in my run for presidency. None of you were expecting that, were you? Oh, and now, as for what's next, it's gonna be even bigger, even greater. I know, and you know.
I also know.
Yeah. Nobody else will see it coming. Even By the time they put me in the history books, I'm gonna be the next George Bush, the next Mother Teresa, the next Pablo Escobar.
Oh, dear friends of mine, of course, how is Pablo doing? My Netflix subscription ran out.
Not so hot.
Well, I expect I'll be seeing the inside of the White House a lot sooner than I expected. I left my hat there when Bush was in, and Obama hasn't let me get it back.
Well, I'm sure you will. I mean, I'm going to kit it out. There's going to be a jacuzzi, champagne bar, a nightclub, the full works. Oh, as for what's next, Papa's still got a trump card up his sleeve.
And once I put my own nefarious plans in place to take over the mine and the underworld, we need only combine our powers above and below ground. And we will be the most powerful creatures this side of the earth. Well, can't you say I'm an important meeting?
There are humans in the mine.
Humans in the mine? Be out with it.
They came in through the Goblin Village. They're there with the Queen. I saw them come in with my own eyes.
How on earth did they get in here?
Through the wall.
The bloody great hole in the wall.
Did somebody say wall?
How do you break a wall like that's a cave wall? Tell me that's the best kind of wall you can get.
I built great walls. My walls? Better than China.
You say that, but this here, this is Goblin Cable. Nearly indestructible. The human wall, on the other hand, I mean, you could get around it in so many ways. You could climb over it.
Yeah, you could get some suction cups, go Mission Impossible.
You could fire yourself out a big circus cannon and go over it.
And you could find a pole vaulter.
You could get lots of cheerleaders into a really big triangle.
Befriend Spider-Man, I guess.
Superman.
Any of the men, really. Or you could fly over it.
Or get a passport and walk through it.
Yeah.
I mean, clearly that you could blow a big hole in it. And walk through the hole.
Think about clearing that bit up.
I better call my team.
Ciao, darling, ciao. Know about these humans.
Well, as I said, I saw them coming in through the Goblin Queen's mine, so I know they've been there for starters. There's a big, tall, posh one, and then there's a shorter little minion of his own, who's sort of poorer and grubbier looking, and then there's a woman, but she's also a man. Obviously, I don't have a problem with that, because I'm really, really progressive.
If they've been talking with the Queen, we should find out what they've been talking about, obviously. We should get the information from the posh one. Obviously, they're weaker.
I actually had a cunning nefarious plan to extract the information directly from him.
Ideal.
I think we should
seduce him. Are you going to go torture? Now, seduce is a better plan. You shall start a makeshift brothel. A slimy, seedy underbelly of society full of skanks and hoes. And you shall be one of them. And I know there are several mitigating factors working against you. You are male, you are slight of frame, you are from the lowest possible social class. But if I know the landed gentry and upper classes of Great Britain, and believe me I do, this will make you simply irresistible to me. And then, once he is in a state of erotic stupor, you shall tease the information out of him like a good little minion. And of course, you won't have a problem with this because you're quite progressive. Dare you defy me!
No, no, sir. I will extract all the information out of him with my sexual beguile and general sexiness.
Great line. Now, buzz off! I, meanwhile, have my own nefarious plans to be putting into place. To the mines seeking riches or power, but soon they and the goblins housing them shall find only pain and suffering!
Shit at each other and wanking five times a day from sheer boredom.
Oh, no. I used to say if there's anything wrong with living that way. You should open your mind a little, Kevin. You're still the drone living under the thumb of the man.
The who?
Not the who, you spanner. The man. The puppet master, the Illuminati, the...
Oh, right, I see. The man. What the fuck does that even mean? Is it some filthy rich billionaire, presumably, who somehow controls everything? What does the man do when he gets home, exactly? Does he sit down with the wife and kids?
Whoa!
And...
Don't make such generalizations, you heteronormative, gender-guessing knob.
Don't use gendered insults, you dick.
Oh, nice one. Turn that against me, why don't you? I'm sick of you bloody conformists doing whatever you're told by any prick in a suit. You gotta question the world around you, Kevin. You're a slave to the system.
The system? We're not stuck in the fucking matrix, you drama queen. Look, there are laws to keep people accountable for their actions, and there have to be authorities, like the JCR, to be... So, it's about it. You either have some of your records on file and go to a shitty open meeting, or... or you let everyone run around being psycho-pedo clowns. I'm sorry, but that's what your freedom really looks like. So why don't you shove that in your spit and toke it, you fucking hippie.
Jesus.
Hi there, guys.
Hi, Rupert.
Sounded like you were having a bit of a debate there. Yeah, just a little chat. About anything exciting?
No, not really. Sorry to be rude, but we better be...
Better head off.
Yeah, you've got that thing to do, haven't
you? Nice to chat to you. See you soon, no doubt.
Aww.
woe is me. Am I so wretched or so dull that I can't even befriend a couple of bloody goblins these days? I wonder why you keep seeing other men.
Something to take your mind off the old struggling strife?
Goodness, where on earth did you come from?
Where will I go?
Oh my!
Sit back and enjoy the ride, baby.
No, I really shouldn't. I have a wife. I'm happily married.
You didn't seem so happily married a moment ago. What was that about wifey seeing other men? If she can see other men, why can't you? Or women, whatever fits your boat.
Sorry, but you've got this all wrong. I'm not at all interested.
Aww. I'm just looking for a man to fill a dad-shaped hole. An encounter between the evil overlord and man will end his reign of terror.
That's it.
I mean, your plan is foolproof. He'll be shitting himself for sure.
Hang on. I thought for a moment there you were working for him.
I mean, I was. But, I mean, after some reconsideration, with a plan like that, there's no point supporting him anymore. I mean, it's a lost cause.
Wow, it'll actually work. You know, if you're looking for a new boss, I'm sure I could put you to work.
No, no way, you old perv. I mean, thank you very much for the kind and loving offer. I, however, have to go now, because considering that I am now one of the good guys, I mean, I should just wait for this all to blow over. And in fact, you shouldn't tell anyone I was here. This should all be erased from your recount of this story later.
Can I just have your number?
I'll add you on Facebook later. Yeah. Catch up later.
Would you believe it? It's going to work. Just one simple greeting, then we'll be able to go home. I can't wait to see the look on my wife's face when I tell her all about this. Bar the last 5 minutes. I can almost smell the fresh air now. Hooray!
Then I left my mum. mum to go and live with my dad, and then my dad left me to go back to my mum. It was not an easy childhood. And then I was mostly working in Tut's shop, and then when I were old enough, in Tut 9. So to tell you the truth, I've spent a fair share of my time down here.
But what about the air and the plants?
In my town, air were black. Plants were black. If you want someone to paint a pretty picture of life up there, you're better off talking to my boss. He's proper landed gentry from the countryside.
Yes, but George, it's the landed gentry that intrigued me. It's the man on the bottom. I like a man who's been walked all over.
Oh, I thought a queen would be more interested in a fancy gent or a lord or a cousin.
But that's what things. And truly, the aristocracy are so dull. All they talk about is wine or cricket or politics. Just tedious stuff, George. And yet everyone expects me to like them. It's so unfair. I can't help being born privileged, can I?
Oh, I thought it'd be nice to be one of them, though. Growing up, you see him on Tip Tally and Tip News. I'd love me a bit of that life.
Well, George, perhaps you and I have something for each other.
All right, but let's get Bubba singing.
Buzzing. There you go, lady. Now, have a nice day, I guess.
Bye.
You fucked it again, Trump.
I've lost my toupee!
Again!
Oh, Christ, it's hot in there.
Right, you'll be in the arse next time. You better be talking shit. Sick. Right. She didn't take the drugs!
They always take the drugs!
Is she Christian or something?
Oh, no. Don't hurt the Christians. They are my friends.
Right, it's time for plan B. Catch, let's fetch the catch. The bucket can stretch to a net. There you go.
Actually driving me completely insane. Like, there's just so many of them, and they walk so slowly, and no one is looking at things. I was like, oh.
Hello! The evil overlord, aka me, is releasing a bunch of absolutely smashing renditions of all your favorite jazz hits, including In a Sentimentally Destructive Mood, Take Five, Prisoners, I've Got You Under My Skin, quite literally, Cry Me a River of Blood, and Fly Me to the Moon, for I wish to call. My dulcet tones, my evil words, it's a sensual elocution. Bye now.
Hi there. You're listening to the sultry tones of the future American president, present JCR president, and past failed speaker's officer, James. It's been many weeks since my last contested election campaign, and I crave the sweet, sweet validation of student politics. Indeed, I have decided to run another campaign for a role I have myself created. Vote James Byrne for president of Cambridge.
I tripped over and actually dropped all my books all over this Bortoris, crushing them alive. I felt really bad about it, but then after a while I thought, you know what, they absolutely deserve it because they're a Taurus. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's really funny. I actually did a very similar thing where a Taurus walked into me and I accidentally brutally smashed them over the face with one of the signs that the punting people use. It was really funny.
You got a problem with noise around college? Don't fucking complain. No problem. Everything's fine. You're at a fucking university. Just deal with it. What's that? You're not getting enough sleep. Oh, boo hoo. What's the problem? It's all fine. Not bothering at all. It's not a problem.
Hello there. Have you been struggling with climbing up and down your mansion? Have you been trying to arise from the deep hole you find yourself in? Do you need to move up and down frequently, in precision and style? Well, you can with the new muscles you'll acquire from my Pilates workout DVD. Set on a beach with tropical breezes and orgasmic releases. Scandalous! Ooh, you get away from home!
Hello. The Pit Club is looking for you.
We are looking for anybody who went to any public school, so...
Yes,
or Harrow. So, any of you Sudden-nosed plebs out there, you can go away, because we are not interested.
We only like people who are very rich.
It's very rich and misogynistic. Only if Daddy owned a private jet and several yachts would even be considered to come and join us.
And you may wonder, why would I want to join such a pit club? Well,
we have the most fun times with all sorts of animals, don't you know?
This one time, Cornelius and I, we found a pig, and you know, one thing led to another.
Hello! Oh my goodness, there is a female creature in the room.
Ah!
I run away!
What the fuck?
Really think, you know, as I look at the poor little Taurus, I look at them. Oh no, oh, poor little Taurus. And then I made a post on Meanbridge about it and saw that too.
Stop it.
Guys, listen here. Trump here, presidential elect Trump, Donald J. Trump. Thank you very much. I am the best. I am the best of the best. I know all the best people. Great people, wonderful people. Unfortunately, these people cannot build a great wall. They're awful people, hypocrites, bastards. Lock them up. So, if there are any great engineers, I would very much like to do business, great business with you. Thank you, build a wall. Trump out.
I'm Derek. I'm looking for love, but not the romantic kind, but the kinky intercourse kind. Goblins have horns, you could say that makes me horny. A very easy one, not probably not too far away. I'm not checking out the girls. I may not be the sexiest of the goblins, but I'm more than make up with it with my massive cock.
This is shit and temp. I'm in the weather.
I hope you enjoyed that very much. I found it funny. Ha 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 ha.
See you next time, folks. I have been watching you.
A pig in a cage on antibiotics.
Indeed, must be a fine imbecile.
Derek, give that to me at once. He wants. Oh no! Some new socks, a formal shirt, preferably blue, medium size, a copy of Led Zeppelin 3 on vinyl, the original Die Hard trilogy on Blu-ray, none of the shit new ones.
Pardon me, Your Majesty, but I'm pretty sure this was his bloody Christmas list.
Hold on. Oh no.
Kevin's a job's worthy knob, and despite the fact I agree with him, he hates me too.
So you're not going to introduce us or even help?
Exactly. I should be a bearer, really. He doesn't like to part with the king much. I'd best get back to the queen anyways and tell her what's going on. I spoke to Kevin, and that's the right protocol.
Well, that's bloody brilliant. Thank you so much.
Oh, good luck, lads. You don't need it.
You know what? I'm having second thoughts about this. What if the reason why nobody ever comes back through that gate is not because there's an evil goblin killer? What if there's just a big fucking drop and they just keep going through and falling off? I mean, it's just that our plan at the moment is just sir hello. And if there is a big fucking drop, or a pack of wolves, or a bear, a humble salutation will do just about fuck all.
I'll be honest, George, those thoughts did all cross my mind. But then, if there were a bear or a wolf down there, then it would surely starve.
So it can only be a nasty bastard goblin.
Well, let's be hopeful. If not one of those, then they must have spelunked themselves to death.
Well, way to go, eh? Right, let's get this over with. Sell off this haggy chap. You can do the honours.
Hello? Is anyone home?
Aye, maybe there is. Who's that posh wanker that wants to know?
Yes, wait, I'm not all posh, guys. We just want to get through that rate, y'all.
You just want to get through the gate. Well, I just wanted an independent squad and look where that got me. Wait, hang on a minute. There are two of you. This posh boy brought a token poppy goblin to try out Ash's good side. He can piss off.
I'm sorry, but I think there may have been a misunderstanding. We're humans, you see. The Queen said humans can pass, and we need to get into the mine.
No way, laddie. You're a goblin, I'm sure of it. A posh son of that. But I cannot go all haggy. You cannot pass.
One of our dear friends was kidnapped by the evil goblin overlord, and we desperately need to get her back.
This is not negotiable! Oh, slimy a river! Nobody goes through the bloody gate because nobody ever comes back! If you think I'm being stubborn or rude, then you'd be mistaken, my lads! It's for your own good! Now, fuck off ye back to the village!
Don't be like that, you high and mighty bodlog.
Oh, just go and fuck yourself already, you no-good hacket fanny windbag.
Let's not escalate the situation.
Fuck off your wet minge bucket. Fuck, small dick, country weight or wanker.
Stop it, you rotten pimpernel.
You soggy arse, no-brock heads.
Flaccid cantaloupe.
You wrinkly old scrotum.
Piss off, you soot-nosed pleb.
Don't get started, you shit-bag scotch egg!
Bloody hell, George. That was a bit racist.
Oh. It's the next door, it can't be racist.
That's not how it works. Now go and apologise.
Don't want to.
Maggie, I'm deeply offended and embarrassed by what my friend just said. And I think she has something to say to you.
Sorry.
What was that?
I said I'm sorry!
Good, you weasel-headed cop-splat wanker! Now just take the bloody key and fuck off! And one more thing. You're a wizard, Harry.
George, you may have got the key, but you have let me down. You have let the company down. And most of all, I think you have let yourself down.
Thank you. Fuck you, Arthur!
Eva!
Off the stage!
I want to suck you I want to suck you off.
Well, that was some quite elaborate foreplay.
Don't play smart with me. The last time I played smart with me...
Outsmarted you!
Shut up! Now, why exactly did you blow your way into our mind? What do you want with me?
Darling, I had no idea you existed.
Bollocks. Next thing, you'll be telling me you don't know about the master race of lizard people.
Oh, no. I've read a lot of them. But Clinton 1 isn't doing very well.
Do not mention that name in this mind. Now, what do you want?
I have many wants and desires. Perhaps you'd like to know how I got stuck in the Buttock mine.
Excuse me, the what?
Well, the small properties of Rupert Buttock. Surely you know that. He's looking to sell the mine to me and retire.
But this is our mine. You humans think you can just buy everything you want.
Money can buy everything, darling. Even happiness, if you look in the right place. Now back to my story. So I've got to inspect the butterfly and see if it's something I'd be into.
And that is when you blew a hole in the wall and trapped yourself in the process, right?
Exactly. That's how we got stuck deep in the butterfly.
What exactly do you think happens to us goblins when you humans start plundering the wealth and resources of our home?
Look, now that I know you're living down here with your little lives, you're just like the grubby little working classes. So cute and interesting. I'm a philanthropist. I feel for them and I feel for you.
You've lost me now, ma'am. What exactly are you trying to say with all these words?
I couldn't mind the spine if it weren't mine. I've made my billions without a single sweatshop, without any child or slave labour. I even pay my taxes, would you believe it?
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Woo! Woo! Taxes. From what I know about human billionaires, that is quite rare. What exactly happens, though, if you don't buy our mine? Will Rupert keep owning it? Will he throw us up in chains?
From what I know of Rupert, he's a principled and gentle chap. I'm sure he'll let you keep the mine.
Bollocks. If that is true, we might have gone a bit overboard with the whole kidnapping thing. Say the truth, it wasn't even my idea, it was the boss's. I mean, we were just meant to extract information from this poor old tosh bloke. Next thing you know, I mean, I'm dressed for lingerie, and then the Overlord is in like a horse with a billionaire orange person.
I don't think power goes to people's heads, makes them do weird things indeed. Has he always been like this?
Not in the good old days. I mean, in the good old days, it was just a bit of fun, you know? Piers Morgan, Casey Hopkins, harmless, right? But ever since then, I mean, he's been hanging out with all sorts. Nigel Farage, Harambe.
It's a slippery slope, my friend. That's why I've always stuck to the good side. Helping the poor and the needy whilst keeping enough to stay above them all.
I mean...
That's always been like this.
I'm nearly 40, right? Trust me, I am. And the Overlord still has me stealing little bits of people's milk and taking away people's towels whilst they're in the showers. I mean, it is absolutely hilarious. It's a bit tragic.
Yes. There should be corporate espionage and tax evasion by the time you reach the 40s.
You know what? You're right. I'm going to try and change. I'm going to become a proper villain. I'm going to do all those things, just like you mentioned.
Minion! Minion! Where the bloody fuck are you? Hey, oh, you sonic little shit! Oh, I've got a wedding to plan! I've got so much shit to be getting on with! I'm so stressed! Can't you see I'm stressed? There's so many things! Oh, I've got to sort out venues! I've got to sort out the guest list! I've got to sort out what I'm wearing! I've got to find a dress! Oh, I've got to find catering! Fucking hell, I always forget about the fucking catering!
We could get the dungeon staff to sort out catering for you, sir.
I'm not eating that fucking shit! Have you been to formal? The duck is always dry! Don't even get me started on this fucking paranoid bullshit! Get Gordon Ramsay down here or something, he's an old friend. They don't know where the fuck you're going! I've got another thing! I've got to sort out a fucking vicar! Or a priest! or a monk, or a monkey. Do we know Dawn of French? She was very good in Vicar of Dibley.
Now that's something I can help you with. You? Why, yes. I happen to be a licensed vicar. Weddings, funerals, you name it. And if you mind me releasing from this dungeon, I'll even do it for free.
I'm a slut for a bargain.
But can we trust her?
Seems like a trustworthy type. Also, to be an amateur vicar is a bit weird, don't you think?
It's a weird hobby, yes. Knitting or something.
Sexist!
I accept your offer, yes. That's where the scene goes. Here's the deal. I shall allow you the privilege of wedding myself and the gorgeous Goblin Queen with several conditions. One, I cannot let you free right now. You being here in the mine with me gives me leverage over the humans, and I cannot afford to have them meddling in my affairs. But if you should do the deed correctly, you will be free.
Well, suits me just fine. I'll unite the two of you in holy matrimony, then be on my way. Pleasure doing business.
Fantastic.
You've got to think about the catering.
Fucking catering! Always with the catering!
Well, boss, we've been spelunking for a good few hours.
Very important to remember this. It's not that everyone hates you.
The vast majority of people don't even care about you.
Topical!
I know I'm not the best at this, but I hope that helped.
Not really. We've got bigger things to be worried about. How far do you reckon it is this nasty bastard goblin?
Well, George, based on the sulphurous aroma and ominous atmosphere, guessing the overlord must be right around the next corner. You ready for it?
Not really. And you know, I've actually had another thought. Because you see, at the moment our plan is, you know, the same old thing. But what if that doesn't work? What if he doesn't just poof into dust the second we pop around the corner? Do we have a plan B?
Don't think about that, George. Now isn't a time for pessimism. Brush any negative thoughts aside and let's just get on with it.
Right.
Let's go defeat an evil bastard and save some goblins. We'll be back above ground before you know.
The smell gets stronger over here. That fucking what have you not been eating?
George, what matters?
Oh, some of his evil minions over here. Look at that one. Look at this state. Oh, and some more. Oh, it gets worse. Definitely gets worse. Oh shit, I've gone into a dead end again. Go back.
Up in the dark crevices again, George.
You know, actually, I think the smell does get worse down here, actually.
I think I don't need
George.
Oh.
On the count of five, then.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Goal!
Oh, shit. It didn't work.
What the fuck do we do now?
Oh, my God. We could just pretend we were popping in to say hello, then leave and concoct a plan to kill him.
I'm not about to go and kill some fucking goblin.
Invite him to the wedding?
Did you know how I feel about the Majesty?
You have to go
hug him.
Excuse me, gentlemen. Can I help you?
No, we were just...
We wanted to invite you to a wedding.
Oh, ideal. Whose wedding?
Your wedding.
Oh, tasty. Which proposal was this? Was this the Goblin Queen or Joanna Lumley? No, I don't want to marry her anymore. Minions, chuck these two Lumleys
away.
No, wait. Chuck in the pit with the other.
I'm a stupid idiot.
Oh, yes.
Stop it.
Well, you vex me at all, Goblin Man. Give me your true message or I shall cut off your testicles and sellotape them to your forehead like googly eyes.
Ideal.
Right, in which case I've got to plan a wedding pretty sharpish. Doesn't matter, I've already packed.
There's been some kind of mistake.
A fucking what has there been? Oh, what? A mistake on my wedding day? I am about to become a kind and courteous groom, and you incite me to murder on my wedding day? No, I should be having none of it. Don't talk to me again, you povo. Oh, fucking catering. Fuck off and get the queen. I'm sorting the catering. I'll talk to Kevin. Don't mind the scene changes.
Well, sir, the big day is finally here. How are we feeling?
Oh, fucking rough. Remind me why I'm doing this again.
To unite the goblin people under the peaceful marriage of yourself and the goblin queen, bring them prosperity and lots of freedom.
Right.
However, it doesn't really gel with your plan of abomination there.
I don't know what I was thinking. This must be what happens when you drink two WKDs and think you're the man.
I mean, I'm just a servant of the Order. Royal protocol does state that.
Oh, shut the fuck up, Kevin! Not now!
Are you sure you want me to be your best man, sir?
Well, who else have I got? Bill Cosby's not answering my calls anymore, and George Long's not allowed to talk to him all night! Fucking Scientologists! No,
wonderful. What I meant was, we should probably get going. This could only get worse if we were late as well.
Not even fucking close. Right, I finally think I'm fucking ready. Right, where the fuck is the vicar? She's late!
Darling,
you're late! Fuck off! Right, give me a quick run through. What do we expect? What's the time to be drunk?
An innocent in Vegas marrying couples off a drive-through. Terrible wedding, so my 40.
A drive-through wedding? I can't have a fucking drive-through bitter at my wedding. This shit has to be legit. I have no time. Give me a quick. Okay, drive for me. It's too late to find another one. Give me a quick rendition. What's the fastest we can do?
Okay, fast. Sure.
Quick, you jibbers, I'm a fool and kiss the damn bra. No! There must be something else. What the fuck was that?
Well, it was a celebrity themed drive-through. What do you mean prefer to be met? That was the Osborne.
Could you use
any dog? I don't need a fucking impersonation at my fucking wedding! I need a normal wedding! I don't want any of your fucking bullshit! Well, have we got time for another bigger? They must be here soon. How long? Shit. Shame it is that it took 1,000 moons for my twisted heart to see such soft, gentle light.
Thank you.
Not you, foul wench!
What a twist. That is genius writing. Clearly, this is
an Alex Bailey production. In fact, if I were reviewing this as a representative of reputable student journalism or the tab, I'd give it 5 out of 5 stars.
Kevin. I shouldn't have let him run away with the evil overlord. What's going to happen to him?
Fuck him. I've seen some pretty weird things at weddings, and I think that can live quite well.
To be honest, Kevin will see more of the world than any other goblin before him.
You're right. Best just put the plight of my closest friend and advisor out of mind. You're all alive and safe after all. Now, I bet you and your friends are excited to go back home at last.
Yes, please, Your Majesty. We spill up to our heart's content.
I'll see to that in just a moment. I have something very important to do before you all leave. Now, Mr. Minion, let's see if we can put you to work somewhere in the royal court.
Right.
Before long, everything will be back to normal. The end is finally in sight.
You're finally running a successful business.
Hey!
better. It is the best. You are looking at the new supreme leader of the United Nations.
Go, darling! Yeah!
You are the head of the UN.
You bet. And I have been talking with the UN Nations, especially China. I know a lot about China. And we have decided that you, the Goblins, should be officially recognized by the UN.
You mean we're going to be an entire country full of goblins?
That's right, buddy. If it keeps you out of America, I'm happy. Now, you're going to need a flag. I know a man who makes great flags if you need help getting a flag.
Oh, thank you so much. How can we ever repay you? I don't know what to say.
Don't worry about it. Dealmaker, heartbreaker, that's me. Now, hold on. I've lost it. Oh, got it. You might want to give this a read. It turns out there's a lot you need to learn to be able to run a country. Now, I've got to see a man about a plan. I'm going to Russia, so Trump out, baby.
Gonna ask them all these bloody details, tell the Queen later. Oh, becoming an entire country is gonna require so much proxy paperwork. Where is the Queen anyway?
Now, let's celebrate!